you want me like that, like that, then be great.
Oh, sorry, sorry, sorry.
Then I cannot think unless she's got a better body, and she got a body better than mine. And I cannot think it when you touched it, were you sorry like you weren't at the time. Loving you is easy, that's why it hurts now. The worst way to love somebody is to watch them love somebody else, and it work out now. I cannot think unless she's got a better body, has she got a body better than mine. Do you love-
You've had a huge 4 years.
It's been big.
Since that first release, but we mentioned.
Yeah.
This year in particular, touring with Ed Sheeran.
Yeah. How's that been? Pretty good. Yeah. I mean, Ed's brilliant, and playing stadiums is just the best thing in the whole world. Like, I love it. And the crowds were insane, and doing it in America as well was just wild. Like, America is a wild place.
And do people know your music there?
Yeah, kind of. Like, there was a few.
That's okay.
But, you know, it's the beginning. It's the beginning of something.
It's talked about breaking in America. I don't think it's a very quick thing anymore.
No, I don't think it's ever been a quick thing. I think, you know, it's massive. Mm-hmm. It's going to take a bit of time.
Touring with Ed Sheeran.
Yes.
Him as an artist, one of arguably the biggest in the world.
Yes.
Other than Elton John. What's he been like convincing his crowds that they're worth your time?
Well, I mean, I've just gone out and kind of done my thing and hoped for the best. Like, yeah. I think music is like food, right? Not everyone's going to like your cooking. No one likes my cooking, so thank God some of them
What's
like my music. Pesto pasta.
That's mine.
Hell yeah,
beautiful,
baby.
Beautiful. Yeah, so what do you put in it? What's the...
A bit of rocket. Maybe a bit of chicken if I'm feeling like I can be arsed.
Cherry tomatoes?
No.
I
hate tomatoes.
That's like the secret little...
That's like my... Not a fan. He's an icon, Ed. And we had a lot of chats while we were in America, and he was helping me with a few things, like navigating the industry, navigating the sort of rise towards whatever I'm trying to rise towards.
Yeah.
So he's a legend. He's great. And I love touring with him. I'm gutted. It's over.
I know, but you've had a very good run. But
yes.
Would you say he's like a mentor to you now? That sort of
oh,
thing.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. That's really nice because you've seen me some people like Macy Peters.
Yeah.
So I'm that kind of person backing you. Even still in an early stage for you.
Yeah.
That's going to be so validated.
Oh, it's brilliant. Yeah, and he's got a good eye.
You've got a new song coming out? Lie a Lie.
I do. I thought you meant Ed. I was like, does he?
You're a big Ed fan.
I'm a big Ed fan, yeah.
Before the tour, were you a big Ed?
Yeah, and I managed to keep, because we share the same management.
Right.
And I was the first artist that the management signed after Ed. And I managed to keep it a secret from them that I was a big Ed fan.
Oh.
When the first time I met Ed, I was in pieces. It was very embarrassing.
I just think that's so special for you as an artist.
Yeah.
To be fans of other artists.
So, yeah. Like, I think it's so important. Like, you can get inspiration from anywhere.
It makes you real. It makes you feel very authentic still, but...
Oh, yeah. Don't worry. I'm still a little fan girl.
Who else are you a fan?
I can't tell you.
Can't tell.
Just in case I ever meet them, / want to date them, and they then go, oh, but you're a little fan girl. Be like, well, me? No. I'm cool, man.
Tell me about the new song.
The new song, Lie Lie.
Right, what's the sound like?
It's the sound that I've been trying to achieve for the last 2 years.
Yeah.
I've found the right people to work with. I found some gorgeous, divine people to make the album with. And it's nearly finished.
Amazing. That's very cool.
But don't get your hopes up. The album's not coming this year, and I'm going to tell you that now, because otherwise Twitter will try and kill me. It's definitely a bigger sound.
Okay.
Which is really exciting. I mean, it's the first of a bunch that are... I mean, I want to call them all sort of wannabe rock pop.
Yeah.
Which is what I call myself. But it's big, and it's catchy. It's definitely one of the more poppier ones. Which I love.
And then that's amazing. And I've seen you played Shepherd's Bush.
I did.
Beautiful show.
Thank you.
And you had such a dedicated audience. People that come and see you, they know your music. It's something that hadn't even come out yet, and we love it.
Yeah.
Having fans like that, really, how does that make you feel? Wow.
Oh, it's special. Like, it gives me a purpose in life.
Yeah.
Which I think is really important. You know, songwriters, we're all a bit
to Lulu.
So it's really important. I'm seeing like familiar faces every show.
Yeah.
Which I know I will be seeing today.
Yeah, Barnes feels like a very dedicated place.
Yeah. No, I've been really, really looking forward to this one.
So what does Barnes mean for you coming back in now to see that kind of full circle? Those fans that you've built up over the last 2-3 years going on tour?
I mean, if I pull it off, hopefully it will be a little pat on the back to myself for making it for another year. But also I love Barn because like there are so many beautiful artists here.
Yeah.
And a lot of them I've met many, many times, and it's just so nice to see them all. And it just feels a bit more like family, you know, than some of the bigger festivals.
And we feel more connected as well.
But also I hate walking. Like, that was one thing about Glastonbury, right? Like I did like 50,000 steps a day. Whereas here, you're not going to do that many.
I think it's a 2 minute walk from my tent to the main.
But I love that.
Oh, I love it.
And yes, all of my favourite artists are playing here this weekend. So that's
brilliant. Yeah. Thank you so much, Dylan.
Thank you.
Lovely to talk to you.
Lovely to talk to you.
Seen Dylan, gang of youth tonight. I'm so excited for the rest of the weekend. Hopefully my voice recovers. Loads of fun interviews coming your way. Can't wait to stick around.
Barn
on the Farm, second year running.
Yeah.
How was it coming back?
It was really fun. I always love Barn on the Farm. It's just quite midsummery.
You feel that absolutely?
Yeah. I just want to see some people get burned at the stake.
Do you?
Yeah.
I'm sure. Is that not the ceremony at the end on Sunday?
I think so.
Not there before, I'm sure.
I'm not staying for Sunday, so it's
Something out. Yeah. Besides the crowd, audience, people know your music a lot more now.
Yeah, actually, I did notice that. It's a little weird. Yeah. I have people singing along.
It's such a lovely feeling.
Yeah, it's really cool. It's really nice.
Did a new song come out as well?
Yesterday.
When you release a song, is this the kind of thing where you release it and you're like, you're refreshing your
beat? Yeah, I try not to do it. I try and plan something on the day to distract myself.
Yeah.
Because I hate release day. Because it's kind of like waiting for exam results or something like that. So, yeah, I just do something else. Like yesterday, I babysat. So
Jose, what keeps you distracted?
Yeah, so, well, yesterday babysitting. Mm-hmm. That was fun.
Great. But you can't sit. Well, you probably can sit back refreshing.
I can, but it was a six-month-old baby, and yeah, so she is like a lot. Yeah, I mean, we played it for the first time live, and so that was exciting for us. But
it was the first time live. I was
first time live.
Yeah, she hadn't played it before it came out.
Never.
Must be really hard to gauge what's the world going to think of this.
I know.
Obviously, yeah. You kind of got demo-itis. You had the same.
Definitely.
Same thing.
Yeah.
You had like we hate. It. It's
yeah.
Out.
And also, it doesn't become yours anymore.
Yeah.
You release it for everyone else. So I always think like the song has kind of died.
Okay.
And I just kind of go, okay, now the next one. Like that's yours.
That's a really interesting.
So, but yeah.
A lot of artists say that while the song remains theirs, it's like someone else's baby now.
Right. Yeah.
But for you, you're detached from it.
Yeah. 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 Like obviously, when I play it live, I'm still connected to it, yeah. But. I'm always just wanting to then do the next thing. So yeah, I was writing it from a female's perspective of just feeling like, I don't know, trying to break out of anything conventional at all.
Oh, yeah.
Because I see myself as kind of as genreless. Mm-hmm. I don't like labeling my stuff.
It's hard to pigeonhole yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
Particularly nowadays, you can cross genres so easily.
Exactly. I think it's way more accessible now to just like not put yourself into a specific genre.
But I'm working with a producer like Matt Maltese.
Yeah, Matt and Josh, they're both like the same,
yeah.
You know? And you just want to write good music and it doesn't have to be a specific thing. Just it has to be good.
I think you're doing that very well.
Oh, thanks.
You're fitting into a lot of different boundaries.
Yeah.
Right, you're pushing things yourself. This new song, because you've got a background in jazz.
Yeah, I do, yeah.
I think, particularly the last couple of things you put out, it's really fun that it's jazz. But crazy.
I heard you say jazz and just wanted
to. Loves jazz. I think your jazz is, you know, back when I was really coming through.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Particularly playing with the full band.
Yeah.
How's it been developing those songs that you wrote to fit with the full band now?
I mean, really fun. I've always wanted to do that. And I think it's more interesting just because we are playing like a very old school kind of band. Like we're not playing with tracking.
Yeah.
Nothing against tracking.
It's all live.
It's great, but it is all live. Which makes it harder, you know, we can't replicate the exact record. But I think that makes it interesting to like come see live,
oh,
the version. And
everything's different.
Yeah.
So your creative process, obviously you say by the end of the song that comes out, you kind of get it going, done.
Mm-hmm.
What's the gap generally between you writing a song? I assume it's different every time.
I wrote Mechanical Bull, I think in around March of this year.
So it's to not me, that long ago.
Not that long ago, but to me it feels like ages ago because of the amount of stuff that you've written since then. So yeah. Yeah, I just kind of write and write and write, and then I go, I like that one.
So you always writing? You always?
Yeah, I don't think I'm always writing. I think, I think there's a pressure of the whole writers have to always be writing. Also, like, part of writing is kind of just doing nothing. I know that sounds like an excuse, but it's not. It's like you need to gather your, I don't know, thoughts or experiences.
So for you, can you write? Is it like therapy? Is it cathartic for you?
I mean, not always. Most of the time, yes. Sometimes I'll write something without really knowing what I'm feeling, and then afterwards it becomes something that feels
more clarity.
Therapeutic. Yeah.
So moving forward into 2023, we're halfway through.
Yeah.
What can we expect from the rest of the year? And a big one for you already.
We can expect a possible tour.
Cool, maybe.
And a possible project at the end of the year.
Okay, we can post that.
And yeah, that more of that.
Amazing. Well, Etta, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
That was me.
Yeah.
I'm here in Saturday, Barn on the Farm. My voice has not returned. Maybe this is my thing now. Maybe I've just got this rasp forever. I've had some beautiful interviews today with Neve, Etta Marcus, Thomas Eden. Really excited to show you those. Beautiful music, just about to see Bleachers, Justin and Olivia Dean, almost cried on my shoulders. Magic, I'll see you soon. I mean, that was my first experience seeing how dedicated your fans are.
Yeah.
They love you.
I love them.
It's really sweet tonight.
We love each other.
Lovely dynamic you have between you though.
Yeah, it's nice. I hate the word fans. It's a weird word, but like I think I got an
people
audience.
That like your music.
People that like my music. I found that majority of them found me at a time when there was nothing to do but be constantly online. I think.
But again, the themes of your music relate to quite a lot of that.
Absolutely, yeah. And so I think it's weird now. Like it's just been the first time that there's a lot of firsts, like once we've come out of COVID now, especially the artists and bands that have existed since COVID, and this has been the first time that like we've had a proper year and a half, 2 years of festival seasons of shows.
Oh, yeah.
Of just like it's still going. Nothing's being shut down. Like there's no like I have to reschedule this because new restrictions or anything. So it's cool. It's been really, really fun to just like have it exist.
But it's tiring for you because your experience of this before COVID was pretty minimal. So
yeah.
Now it's just full on action.
Totally. But like I think it's like what you your like perception of it changes because I love it. Like I dreamed of this before COVID and now I'm tired. But it's still a lot of fun.
But you're in the midst of it now.
Yeah, I am.
You're on tour at the moment.
I am.
You're 6 days here.
6 days here.
6 days across Europe.
6 days across Europe.
Which I think is a bit crazy because UK is tiny compared to all of Europe.
Yeah.
You've got to do 6 days a couple.
Yeah.
Whole continent.
That would be a big tour. It's
got
like
every city in every.
A lot of traveling. This tour is actually very. I looked at the routing this morning. It's very easy.
Yeah.
It's like tonight we're driving 15 minutes away.
Where?
I don't know. A hotel apparently.
Oh, yeah. Nice. But you're not driving.
Oh. No, I was going to drive a 2009 Toyota, but we've just found out, like, literally yesterday, because we, genuinely, sorry, here's a story.
No, dude.
I bought a car. The label bought me a car.
Yeah.
And we were going to drive it around, and it was like, the cheapest car in the fucking world. It was a piece of shit, 2009 Toyota. We were going to drive it around, and then lovely Lucy from my label called a bunch of insurance companies to sort it all for me, and they were like, he can't drive here.
Oh no.
He's got like an Australian license.
Well, it doesn't work here.
Well, it does, but only for a year, and I've been here over a year.
Oh my God.
So it's just like.
Sorry, guys, I'm gonna have to push the tour back.
Dude,
Thomas has to do my. I've got to do
like,
my theory test, got to do my practical. So, you've got to wait a while for practical at the moment.
I've heard this actually.
Long.
COVID waits.
Yeah. I'm lost.
Damn. Okay.
So, yeah. So that's off the cards?
Yeah, it's off the cards. I'm not driving. But we still have a Toyota.
Okay.
My manager is.
Sweet. So that's really cute.
It's fun.
Yeah. Are you carrying all your stuff?
No, that's in a van.
Okay, right. Oh,
all that's
the magic.
Well,
cut that
it does ruin the magic. But
I like the idea that everything kind of strapped to the roof
in
a big trailer.
Yeah.
And we need to just keep on brand.
I think in our car.
Okay.
So.
That's really cute.
Yeah.
But seeing fans across Europe as well.
That'll be fun. I'm very excited for that.
Like we said before, you started in this in a time where people can really go out.
Yeah.
You saw those numbers build up, but you connect them to real people.
Mm.
Seeing them across the world now.
Totally.
It's amazing.
Yeah. 100%. And it's even like, what's the craziest thing is, it was a girl who came to my show last night. She was like, I'm from Denmark.
Yeah.
And she was like, I flew here for this because you're not coming to Denmark. And I was like, first of all, one, I'm sorry. Two, like, that's crazy. Like,
and you could have come somewhere closer.
Yeah.
Like Paris. It would have saved you a little bit of a journey.
Yeah. Bless her though. It was amazing. It's just like, as you said, it's just kind of crazy.
Yeah.
It does. I still feel like it'll sink in when I like have kids.
Yeah.
But like for now, I'm just like,
No, you're just hanging out.
I'm in a field.
In the field,
fun.
Just do this kind of thing.
Just do this.
Well, let's do this more.
Let's do it more.
Where are we going to be next?
I don't know. We should be somewhere else crazy.
Just want you close to me. Yeah. Talk until we fall asleep. Beautiful. Ooh. Look from now on my screen. Yeah. 3,000 miles feels so damn far. But a cherish every call I do. Here we go.
Just not made to last. Cause we put too much pressure on ourselves. Keeping up appearances to please everybody else. It's hard to leave us in the past. Perfect's just a lot to us. We're meant to be, just not made to last. We were meant to be, just not made to last.
We were meant to be, just not made to last.
Everybody's dancing in the moonlight. Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody's feeling warm and bright. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody's dancing in the
Sunday night and Barn on the Farm is over. I've had an absolutely wonderful time. My voice is shot, but that has not affected how much I've enjoyed this beautiful festival. Highlights for me have really been Olivia Dean, spectacular performance. Wonder Horse just brought so much energy. And then just the general environment of this festival. It really feels like a place full of creatives and other artists just supporting each other, looking out to find their new favorite artist. Exactly what I've done. Nivella, always a highlight for me. So much more I wish I could have seen. So that's why I'm so sure I'll be coming back this time next year. My favorite festival in the world, and I've done a lot, so that says a lot. Can't wait to come back. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you again next year. Mate, have you stopped it?
Yeah. Buried under the arches, oh yeah.